Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Lunar, Eternal Blue. I'm the RPG chick, playing blind. We're in the town of Larpa. And that's not Larper, Larpa. No, I haven't found any role-playing adventures here of the live-action variety. Well, hello there. Sit down and take a load off those tired feet. The girl doesn't look too well. Why don't you have a drink? And every time we get in a fight, sir, she collapses. Fruit! Sweet fruit! Only 5,000 silver each. Get them while they're fresh. Better be made out of gold. Boy, that girl doesn't look too good. You better buy her some fruit! Ruby says, no way, hero. This guy is charging outrageous prices. Yeah, you don't have to tell me that. I don't have that money to give him in the first place. Right now, I'm just a lousy, stinking bar wench, but one day my knight in shining armor will ride through those doors and sweep me off to a new life with shimmering palaces and dazzling wealth. Ruby says, I think you better lay off the romance novels for a while, sister. Fabio ain't coming for you, I'm sorry to say. Some toughies over here. Hey, kid, beat it. Can't you see I'm busy with my game? The magic that puts monsters to sleep is very handy. If they're asleep, even tough monsters become pretty easy. Yeah, well, my grandpa had that spell, and he left us the no good, dirty, rotten. Hey, don't you bother me now. Can't you see I'm busy? So I hear you're looking for Ronfar. That guy is the best-looking bad boy in town. What a hunk. Just keep an eye out for the hottest guy in town. That'll be Ronfar. Sorry, it's hard to tell with these sprites, you know? Are you Ronfar? So, you're looking for a priest named Ronfar. Well, what are you doing in here? No priest would hang out in this joint. Well, we heard he's an ex-priest. Something say, guys, something about Ronfar. I mean, why not forget about him and join me for a nice game of dice? It must be him. He traded up the altar for dice, someone said. I promised to go easy on you for the first couple of rounds. Well, what do you say? I know that if you were a man, you'd take a shot at wealth. Tell you what, if you win, I'll give you my house. But if I win, I get you a little flying cat thing. I'm sure I can find some use for it. Pet shop, zoo, stew, something. Oh my god, Ruby says liar, cheat, barbarian. Why would you want to eat me? Well, wax my eyelashes and call me hairless. A man that won't gamble. Amazing! Come on, hero, let's get out of here. This barbarian has nothing to offer us. Let's run far. I know it's run far. Oh well. We'll be back for you. You traded the cloth for the dice. Check out the alleys and bars. That was him, I know it. What's this? Nothing here? You know, just between you and me, the best looking man here is Ronfar. He's just good enough to eat. Yeah, we want to eat my cat. And control. When the dice are in his hands, it's almost like magic. Yeah, right. Magic. I'm so impressed, I'm yawning. Let me ask you. The guy in the bar, same as Ronfar, right? You aren't eating, are you? Because I'm standing right in your way here. The town is filled with drifters and lowlifes, so be careful. If and they come up to you, tell them old Ben warned you about their tricks. Say, while you're here, mind telling me what you whippersnappers do? Well, sounds to me like you're some sort of archaeologist or something. I don't understand any of that stuff no more. When I was young, I was the best-looking girl in Larpa Village. But now that everything is sagging to the cellar, no one looks at me anymore. Oh boy. Old people problems. Yes, you chiseler. Ha ha ha. Well, then you're on to my little tricks. Keep it under your hat, okay? Like I see some new folk over there. We will learn all of them. That sanctuary is to the goddess Althena. Some say that the end of the world is at hand. I think they're right. I don't know if even the goddess Althena herself can save us. You know, I'm not sure the goddess Althena even exists. You don't want to say something about that, Lucia? What in tarnation is that freaky red thing flapping over your shoulder, boy? Hey, you call him freaky, goober. I'm a red dragon, and you better show me some respect or I'll toast your hide. Wah-ha-ha, I didn't know red dragons were now coming in bite-sized packages. Oh, really? Well, have you ever seen a bite-sized package do this? Ouch! Hey, you burned me, you little runt. Should have had an animation of that. Now then, what do you have to say for yourself, Peg? Well, you can blow fire all right, you lousy furry lizard. What did you say? Oh, nothing. Nice day, huh? Okay, I got the point. The little one there can blow fire. Big whoop. Alright. I think we'll go in this first, and then we'll go in the other thing. We are the guardians of Althena's truth. Through us, the world will come to know Althena's goodness, if they donate enough. But in all this time, we have not made even one person here convert. The town is crawling with sinners. We've got all these other doors to go through. The most important thing we all possess is a willing spirit. The goddess will not help those that are not willing to help themselves. They all have these giant brains. Ah, yes, I sense that the girl in the red robe is fading from us. Red robe. Quick, donate to Althena and pray for her mercy. Ruby says, I really don't think that's going to work. Say, do you happen to know a priest named Ronfar? Priest? Ronfar is no priest. He has traded his calling for implements of sin. The miserable failure, Ronfar could have been the greatest priest of all. If you offer your silver to the goddess Althena, you will grow strong. Can I read the book? Are you still trying to break the curse on the poor girl? The goddess is good to those that serve her well. Especially if they donate in cash, right? Ruby asks. Can I read this book? No. Alright, let's go through these little doors here. Hello? Pretty blonde girls? Those miserable souls do not understand the danger our world is in. If they did, they'd be crying like babies. Since the goddess Althena herself resides in Pentagulia, only specially chosen ones may enter its hallowed halls. Lucia, I forget their names. Lucia says, Althena resides in Pentagulia. I'm dreaming of the day I am chosen to serve in Pentagulia. There's a rumor floating around about that dog, Ronfar. They say he's been learning new tricks in Pentagulia. There's a downstairs, too. Oh! He just brought us outside. Can't look at that. Just bring us outside too. Ooh, we're freaking out over there. Yeah, we're stuck in here. We can't go anywhere. Alright, pick a door and go through. Okay, up to that big mansion or whatever that is. Hello? Are you members of the Cult of Althina? Go away! We don't want any of your sick mumbo-jumbo. What? You're not? Sorry. If you're looking for the mayor, he's on the second floor. You're looking for the mayor? Head up the stairs to the second floor. Scrubbing down this house over and over is so utterly mindless. If I don't find a new job, I'm thinking about going on welfare. At least then I can do what I want and still get a check twice a month. Ruby says, sounds like a plan to suck your life down the toilet. Did I ask for your opinion on my lifestyle? Just stop bothering me. I've regretted getting into that card game from the moment it was over. If I hadn't wagered myself, I'd never be in this place working like a slave. It sucks to be in debt. Be smart. Don't start. Believe me, I know what I'm talking about. Never wager more than you can pay. Once I work my way out of this hellhole, I'm giving up gambling. That was a totally dead-end way of life. Maybe I'll move to Dalton. It's not a door, right? No. My name's Wanda. I'm the head maid in this place. If you think supervising lousy, stinking, lazy maids is easy, about one damn hour and my stinking shoes will change your stinking mind. Okay. Stinking. I gotta get out of this stinking line of work. I was thinking of attending Maeve Del Blotto's cash flow seminar this weekend. He promises to give away the secrets of wealth for only 299 stinking silver. There's some smelly silver. Can we look at these books? To Hell and Back, A Love Story. I.A. Freeman. Secrets of Supervision, Volume 3. 101 Whip Techniques. How to Win at Dice in 3 Easy Steps. I am cheating. Hilarious. This town is full of shady characters and outright crooks. If you ask me, I think the mayor is the biggest swindler of all. Say, keep that comment I made about the mayor under your hat, okay? I need this job. Even young people in this town are lazy, no-good losers. I guess that's to be expected when most of the adults are that way. Guess so. What's with all these sacks? You think it's sacks of gold, but I can't open them. Pretty girl. Duh, oh, looky here. You come to play with me. Yippee! Let's play house. Okay, it's a really little girl. Nope, we're just gonna walk away and, like, talk to people. This gambler's town is no place to raise a child. Our daughter needs schooling and friends, but this town is nothing but scoundrels. I wish my husband would clean this town up. After all, he is mayor. Say, just keep away from our daughter. You look like another bad influence, and I'm telling you, she doesn't need it. She's got several out-of-town suitors, and I don't want her chances ruined. The little tiny thing that wants me to play with her? She's gonna marry and get out of this town if it kills me. Ruby says, is she serious? Yeah, really, that's what I was thinking. I thought maybe she had another daughter. Those kooks from the cult of Althena came to town and set up shop recently. All they do is beg for money to make bigger shrines. Jeez, I didn't think that was what Althena was about. No, I don't want to talk about those weirdos from the cult of Althena. All it does is get me in a bad mood. My boss is a pretty greedy guy. He wants money for everything he does. He's got this town tied up on his little pinky. But don't tell him I said that, okay? I never argue with the boss. He's kind of temperamental sometimes. Oops, I call him boss. He don't like that too much. It's a habit from the old days, before he bought the election. Whoop! Look what I've gone and done. Don't repeat what I just told you. The boss, mayor, is in the room behind me. Go right ahead and go on in. Hello, I'm the mayor of Larpa. Pay me and I'll tell you anything. Shh, as if I'd pay you. Well, you don't have to be rude about it. Just remember, I'm here if you need me. Where's Ronfar the priest? Ronfar? No, can't say that I know that name. There's no priest named Ronfar in the local Althena cult. Information. All for the price of a small meal. So how about it? Tell me about Ronfar. Tanmar. Yes, there was a man named Tanmar that died about 5 years ago. Is he taking our money? 2195 silver. Ask me anything. I'll surely try to help you, if you can pay the price. But don't ask me about this Ronfar fellow, because I honestly don't know him. I'm sure he took some of our money. Well, that was not helpful. Kind of go back to the bar. I hope he fesses up about who he is this time. Oop, wrong way. I saw the mayor. We need a change of music here. No, let's go here. That's not what we're looking for. There you go. Change of music. Alright, Ronfar. Press up. Say, guys, isn't it a waste of time to look for this Ronfar guy? I mean, why not forget about him and join me for a nice game of dice? I promise to go easy on you for the first couple of rounds. It's him! I just need to turn to him. Somebody's gotta help me. All right, who's gonna help us? I don't think we should be going to Dalton just yet. I found him, I can't do anything. What do I do? What do I do? Cause... Do I need to visit the sanctuary again? Maybe we should donate 100 silver. Will you help us now? Specially chosen ones may enter its hallowed halls. Yeah, I've seen this. He's not in Pentagulia. He's right in that tavern. I just can't. I'd like to play the game with him in order for him, in exchange for him to reveal himself to us. I don't know what to do. Do I need to talk to these people again? Okay, we're just about out of people here. I don't remember exactly how much money we had, so I don't know if we took anything. I am getting bored. And, try one more time. I mean, how do I just play dice with them? How I play dice? Play me some dice. Ah. the other place is to the west. Where? Okay. What's up here? Oh, there's another town. I'll see what that beach is, though. Ooh! Two scorpions. There's a boomerang, simmerang, simmerang. Herb for hero. Nothing, okay. Dalton, I presume? Welcome to Dalton! Ships from all over the world come to this very famous port. Oh, that statue's broken. I can't imagine what kind of deviant would have the gall to do this. Now how will weary travelers refresh their spirits? Who gives a rip? I don't. That is exactly the kind of apathetic reaction I'm talking about. Is nothing sacred to you anymore? Does your life have no meaning? Heretic. I was just wondering that, actually. Well, there is a statue just like it in the shrine of the Athena cult. It's kind of weird in there, but their statue does work. Heretic. Hey! Hey! Do you know the names of the four heroes of Athena? No, tell me about it. Oh, goody! I was hoping you'd say that. I love reciting them. The first of the four heroes is White Knight Leo, Lord of Athena's Guard. Yeah, we met the guy. Second is Saint Lun, Master of Blue Dragon Karate. Third is Grand Black Wizard Borgen. And last is Oh yeah, the last hero is Red Priest Mari. I learned all about them at the School of the Althena Cult. Memorized that myself. Aren't you proud of me? You told me, you dumb kid. Oh, yeah, I told you about them already, didn't I? I spaced and forgot. You probably think I'm the world's youngest Alzheimer's patient. Alright, guys. Stay tuned for next episode when we look around here some more. Hopefully get something done. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang, bang, boogie. And don't stop the boogie.